to the statics tutorials. So for this problem, let's say that we just solved a 3D particle equilibrium, and we have a sum of forces in x equation, we have a sum of forces in y equation, and a sum of forces in z equation that we need to solve and get a force for F1, F2, and F3. We can go through this process with something called substitution. So looking at our three equations, try to figure out if one's equation is a little bit easier than the other. The sum of forces in z equation has a constant term in it, so it's a little bit longer than the sum of forces in x or the sum of forces in y. Let's start with the sum of forces in x, and then we're just going to rearrange it so that we have f1 equal to something. So we go ahead and take the 0.3 F1, negative 0.3 F1 here, add it to both sides of the equation. That'll bring the 0.3 F1 over to here. Now let's write it here, 0.3 F1. It's equal to then the rest of the equation that we have here. So 0.5 F2 plus 0.1234 F3. We can just then divide through by 0.3. And doing the math, that gives us F1 is equal to 1.667 F2 minus 1.4113 F3. Now we're going to need to take our next easiest equation. Let's just use our sum of forces in the Y. And then we'll bring it down, but in place of F1, we'll substitute out what we've already solved for. So we have 0.6 F1, that'll become 0.6 times this 1.667 F2 minus 1.4113 F3 here. And then just carry on with the rest of the equation. So your 1.457 F2 and your negative 0.2758 F3 here. Then we'll go ahead and combine all the like terms. So we'll distribute this through. Add up all of our F2s, so we have 1.146 F2. Add up all of our F3 terms, so we get negative 0.5226 F3. Then we'll add the negative 0.5226 F3 to both sides to send it over, and we'll divide through by this coefficient, so we just have F2 now is equal to 0.456 of F3. Now we take that last equation, bring it down, but make the substitution again. So instead of F1, we have that substituted in for F1. Go through, combine the terms again. So we have 2.090 F2 plus 0.5370 F3. Let's go ahead and add this constant term to both sides to send it over to the other side. And we'll have our 900 newtons there. Then from here, go ahead and make this second substitution. So F2 is 0.4560 F3. Substitute this in here for F2. Now, everything on this side of the equation is a function of F3. You can go ahead and combine all those terms, and you get 1.490 F3 is equal to 900. And then you just divide through by this coefficient to get F3 is equal to 604 newtons. Go back up to this equation now. Your F2 is equal to 0.4560 F3 and substitute that value that you just calculated in for F3. And that'll get you that F2 then is equal to 275.4 newtons. We could round that off to 275. And then go back to your first equation that you got, where you have F1 is equal to 1.667 F2 minus 0.4113 F3. Make both of those two substitutions for F2 and F3, and then you'll get that F1 is equal to 211 newtons, and you solved it. Because there's a lot of algebra in here, you may also want to go to a website that can solve systems of linear equations. So, for example, Wolfram Alpha. Or you can just Google systems of linear equation solvers, and you can just type in your coefficients here, and it'll go through and solve them. So it's a good way to kind of double-check your work. Obviously, though, on an exam, you'd want to be able to go through and solve it this way. If you only had two equations and two unknowns, all you need to do would be to make make this first equation where you have f1 as a function then of just f2, then you could just substitute it into your second equation, and then you'd be all set. But with the three equations and three unknowns, you have to do the one, two steps before you substitute into that last equation. Thanks for watching. Bye.